start by asking Amit Malviya to lay out why you believe that Twitter, in the statement that they've put out, the position that they've taken, hitting out at the government, questioning your motives, questioning whether freedom of expression will be imperiled by your government's move, why do you believe that what this California-based tech giant is doing is wrong and that Twitter ought to fall in line and comply with law? Mr. Amit Malviya.
Well, first of all, India is one of the largest democracies in the world. We have a constitution that has provisions to protect freedom of right and expression of citizens. And no private entity, whether it is Twitter, Facebook, WhatsApp, or any other social media platform for that matter, can be above law. And Twitter must realize this sooner, the better it is. Now, coming to this law in particular, what does the government of India want these tech giants to do? Appoint a resident compliance, contact, and grievance redressal officer. That is not a big ask. It also clearly says that under four categories, which is terrorism, law and order, child pornography, and sexual crime against women, if the government asks for certain information on the people who may have used their platform, then the agencies have the right to do so, whether through a judicial order or through designated people, and these social media companies must comply. Now, let me give you a few examples to illustrate why these tech giants have applied their own policies inconsistently. When you had the Capitol Hill seize, they went ahead and acted against some users. But when a similar siege was laid on the Red Fort and the government of India demanded for people who had been using their platform, they were not forthcoming. They deplatformed a sitting US president as if he did not have the right to expression and free speech, and made it about community standards. Now, if you look at their behavior in countries such as Germany, in the United Kingdom, in France, in several African countries, in Brazil, everywhere they have been accused of interfering in the democratic process of that country. You have on the one side,
okay,
the former Indonesian Prime Minister put out rabid tweets asking for killing of French nationals, but that is not taken down. But a similar tweet on the other side is promptly acted against.
Okay, so you made an important point, and I want to go across to Mishi Chaudhary for her first counter to what the government is saying. Let's take the Sambit Patra love and manipulated media. Twitter decides this is manipulated, doesn't tell us why it thinks that tweet is manipulated. They could have good reasons, maybe they don't. But is Twitter the one who will decide, or will an Indian court be the one who determines and decides? Amit Malviya's main argument is that these tech giants act arbitrarily, they act in line with their own political ideology, and how can they say that they will not comply with Indian law? If they're operating in India, they have to fall in line and operate according to Indian law. Mishi Chaudhary.
Thank you, Rahul. First thing I'm going to say here is rights which Mr. Malviya is talking about, freedom of speech and expression and right to privacy, they are provided under our Indian constitution against the state. The state, that is government of India, is bound by the constitution to protect and guarantee these rights to its citizens. It's not the responsibility of a private company to either protect these rights or offer them. That's the first thing I'm going to say. The second thing is, these are private businesses and they have their terms and conditions about, like any business would have, that you can go into a shop, they say, okay, these are the various things which we can offer and we can allow you to enter. There are some laws which we have to follow and we will follow. And I will say, this is not a counter. What has happened is the big platform companies, the ones which we are now talking about, Facebooks, WhatsApps, and the Twitter of the world, they definitely have become big enough that they need regulation. However, the problem which has happened here is that various issues have been conflated. Sometimes it is about privacy. Sometimes it is about free speech and expression. The other times it is about when what is required by them in order to check misinformation, that becomes a dispute. So instead of using things like antitrust, a separate data protection bill to protect the right of privacy, and also talk about content regulation, which is takedown of stuff, which is blocking access to certain information, all of this is clubbed together, and every random thing is thrown in the name of saying we want to check fake news, we want to take the control the powers here of the companies. So this is much more nuanced than saying, oh, I'm going to provide a counter, Mr. Malviya is going to talk about the government, because I think both of these stakeholders who have a lot more power than the citizens are holding a theater in the time of a pandemic and trying to distract. I will say about these specific rules, which are the law right now, because these are subordinate legislation. The parliament hasn't met for the 30 days since they were notified. In these very rules, Rule 3B10 requires a platform like Twitter to tell its users and then not upload any information which is patently false and untrue, it is written or published in a manner with the intent to mislead. So you cannot pass a law and say that you must do something if an information you have found to be patently false. So Twitter in this case comes across some information, finds it to be patently false and untrue, and then labels it. A, there is no law which prevents or which gives the power to the government to interfere between what happens between one individual and what happens between this party, which is Twitter here. There is just no
sure, power. But in which case can Twitter act as judge and jury? That's the point.
No, let me complete. That's the problem which the government wants them to ask. The rules require Twitter and Facebook, etc., to become judge and jury, because the rule earlier was only on a court order or a government order, which is a reasoned order, can you take any action. Okay. So